Hey guys, WhiteFox1225 here with another video, and today we're talking about Doom 2016, the new Doom game that's coming out next year. So we're just going to go over all the details and everything like that. I know I did a video on this like a little bit ago, but we just got so much news at E3, I pretty much had to make a new video, giving you guys all the updates and the cool stuff we know about the game so far. So we're going to be going through the story, the co-op, the map maker, the multiplayer, pretty much everything you can name about the game we're going to be covering in this video. So let's just start off with the story. So we don't know a lot about the story or the single player, but what we know about the story is that it takes place on a UAC facility and it's being invaded by the forces of hell. So nothing that sounds that unique, we've seen that before, you know, it's pretty much what the Doom games are kind of set around. So that's, you know, pretty Doom, you know, we kind of knew that was going to be the story, but we haven't seen like any talking or anything. The gameplay demo that they did didn't have any like dialogue or anything like that, and the dev said that the story is not really the main focus, even with the single player. So I was kind of hoping for something like Wolfenstein, where it's kind of like an old school shooter with like a really story driven, you know, set of characters and like all these cutscenes, but it looks like that's definitely not what we're going to get. It's going to be like there's a little less emphasis on the story and more just on the gameplay here. Speaking of gameplay, let's just get into that real quick. So it is still focusing on the old school mechanics. If you guys don't know, Doom is a really old series, goes back all the way to the 90s, and it's really loved. But really what it's based around is just fast-paced movement and constant action. So you're not going to be taking cover in Doom, you know, the devs have already said that. You're just going to be constantly moving. It's kind of like a run and gun. You're going to be jumping, you can double jump in the game. You're just going to be, you know, running around, and you can see on the gameplay on the screen what I'm talking about. Now, one thing that devs did to make sure that you're always moving is that your health does not regenerate in the game. So, you know, taking cover, you're not gonna all of a sudden go back to full health. You don't have an option. You can pick up health throughout the map, but you're not gonna get it by just sitting in cover and recovering. You know, so that's just one thing they did to make you have to keep moving. So if I had to sum up the gameplay, it's really fast paced and it's really, you know, run and gun style, just like the old Doom games. Now, going into the guns and the weapons, I'll list them a little bit later in the video, but you're going to start out with a base gun, and through exploration you're going to find modifications pretty identical to Wolfenstein's system. So again, looks like it's taking some inspiration and from the success of Wolfenstein. If you guys don't know, Wolfenstein is also a very old shooter that they brought back just like last year or 2 years ago, and they made a really great game, and I think they're kind of taking some inspiration from Wolfenstein and trying to, you know, use some of those features that really worked well for the game. Now, moving on to the enemies, it looks like they have fairly low health. A lot of them you're killing in one shot with a shotgun or something like that. There will be boss fights in the game. We actually saw one at E3, so prepare for that. But they look pretty cool from what we saw, that little snippet in E3. And again, if you look on the screen, you can see the gameplay that I'm talking about. Let's talk about the takedowns and the kill cams, because these are really awesome. So when you get close to an enemy, you can do like a melee attack, or what's called like a takedown. They're really brutal, you know, you're not using your gun, you're kind of just like taking the enemy down in one swing. It's a, you know, like a, once you do it, you're gonna kill them, but the way you do it all the time is different. You know, you can rip someone's leg off and shove it through their head. I know that sounds pretty brutal, but it looks so sick on the screen. You know, you can stomp people's heads off. There's like a bunch of these different takedowns. That's what I'm calling them. I'm not sure what the devs are calling them, but they look really cool. One thing that they really put an emphasis on is that they're really quick and they don't really interrupt the flow of the game, or you're not gonna get like destroyed while you're out in the open doing this like, you know, slow, you know, kill takedown. It's gonna be really fast and go with the flow of the game. But these look really cool. Again, they're absolutely brutal. And you guys can see on the screen, I know I've said that a couple times, if you guys can see a couple clips of these, they look really intense, and I'm really excited to use them. Moving on, let's go into the interface. I just wanted to touch really quickly that it looks really clean. I really like the way ammo and health and all that stuff drops. It just looks really great, and also the graphics just look absolutely beautiful, really clean, and really just next gen, which is really exciting. Let's go into the co-op. So we don't know that much about the co-op, but we do know is that it'll be survival. You'll have to survive waves of demons, so nothing too special. We've seen that in, you know, quite a few games. Hopefully they'll do it a little differently and it'll work out pretty cool. But we do know there will be a co-op, so that is in the game. Now let's get into the last part, which I know everyone's excited about, especially me, which is the multiplayer of Doom. This has really kind of been a fan favorite. It's really kind of what drives the Doom games is the multiplayer. So this is probably what we've heard, I'd say, probably the most about, even though we haven't really gotten to see it that much. So we did hear quite a bit, but let me just start with saying the multiplayer is still really fast-paced. It's still Doom. One thing they did is make sure there's no long sight, no long lines of sight. And again, health doesn't regenerate, so you're gonna have to keep moving, and there's really no advantage to taking cover. There's also gonna be a reason to move around the map is those power-ups that are placed around the map. So you can get a few of them. They all do different stuff. So one is gonna turn you into like a Doom demon who has rocket launchers on his back, and that's really cool. Apparently they're pretty powerful too. So, you know, there is a reason to move around. Besides just your health not regenerating, you're really going to want to find these power-ups and get these awesome weapons, because there's also going to be weapons around the map. There's like a gun that helps you see through walls. There's also a gun that gets more powerful the more you move. So there are some pretty cool weapons around the map, and again, that's just incentivizing you to just move around the map a lot and move pretty quickly. So they said there will be some sort of progression in the game, even though they haven't gone in detail about that at all. You know, whether or not there'll be like levels and unlocks, we're really not sure. But they said there will be some form of progression, so we'll have to wait and see. I think progression is pretty important though in multiplayer games now, so it'll be interesting to see what they come up with. But moving on, let's talk about the weapons. So you're gonna be able to carry two weapons and one piece of equipment with you. It's not like the single player where you can carry all the guns. You know, by equipment I just mean something like a grenade or something like that. But let's go into the list of weapons. We have the chainsaw, the combat shotgun, the super shotgun, the heavy assault rifle, the plasma rifle, the chain gun, the rocket launcher, the BFG, the Gauss rifle, and that's only in the multiplayer, and the static cannon, and that's also only in the multiplayer. So those are all the weapons we have confirmed to be in the game. Some of them are pretty favorites coming back from the old Doom games, especially the shotgun and the chainsaw. Let's go into the game mode. So we have Domination, Freeze Tag, Team Arena, and Straight Up Deathmatch. So obviously we've heard of some of those, like Domination is Domination like Call of Duty or something like that. You know, Straight Up Deathmatch is probably just, you know, a Straight Up Deathmatch, which is every man for themselves. And then Freeze Tag and Team Arena I'm not too sure on, but you can kind of guess from the names kind of what they'll be. One cool thing they're adding is that there is also a map creator in the game. So, you know, the modding community has been pretty involved in Doom, and it's really cool that they're putting a map editor in the game. Anyone can make co-op maps, single player maps, or even multiplayer maps, and it looks really easy to use. It's called Snap Map, and one thing that's really nice about it is it has a really like clean interface, really easy to use. You don't need to know programming or anything like that. Think of it more as the map editor in like Grand Theft Auto or Far Cry, and less like the, you know, creator kit from Skyrim or Fallout or anything like that. It looks really, really clean and easy to use, and I'm pretty excited actually to make some maps. It does look, like I said, just really easy to use, like anyone can pick it up and make some maps for themselves. So that's all I have for the multiplayer, guys. The beta is going to come out in the spring for the people who pre-ordered Wolfenstein. Probably this spring, might come like a little bit earlier than that, you know, January, February, or something like that. But the people who bought Wolfenstein will also randomly be selected for the alpha testing. So if you are selected, I'm sure they'll make some sort of announcement and you'll get an email. So keep an eye out for that. It's going to be released on all platforms. That's Xbox One, PlayStation 4, and PC early next year. So I'll definitely be looking forward to it, and I'll keep making videos on it as more information comes. So make sure you guys stay tuned here. I hope you guys enjoyed the video. If you liked it, give it a like. If you want to see more, make sure you subscribe. If you want to check out my Instagram or Twitter, make sure you do that in the description below. Thank you guys for watching as always, and I'll see you in the next one.